Okay. Aloha, welcome. My name is Master Paul, and I am honored to be here today. Today I'm in a classroom, and the classroom is still in the process of filling up, but it's 2 o'clock, so we're going to go ahead and get started. So, what is this class? This is on the Tao of Healing for reversing pain and aging. So, I want to start by introducing myself and my teacher, why I have the ability to teach what I'm about to teach. My teacher is Dr. Master Jigong Sha. Now, Dr. Master Sha, here's a photo of him. He is a world-renowned healer, literally world-renowned. He has a doctorate in regular medicine, American-based medicine. He's also a doctor of Chinese medicine. And he's trained under a lot of the Chinese top masters. So Tai Chi, he became a Grand Master. Qi Gong, he became a Grand Master. Feng Shui, he became a Grand Master. Yi Qi, he became a Grand Master. So in all these unique disciplines, that's normally take at least 10 years to become a Grand Master. He'd already become a Grand Master in all of them. And he had done become a doctorate in multiple levels. His mission was to serve humanity. And that's why he started out as a doctor. Mm-hmm. And when he started training underneath these other masters, what they taught him was some of the things I'll be sharing with you today. How to reverse pain, how to reverse aging. Now, Dr. and Master Sha has written 20 books, 22 books now. His most recent one is called Soul Over Matter. And so he's delved into a couple of different areas. One previous book was called Soul Mind Body Science, in which he was trying to bring together the blockage areas between mainstream religion and science, because once they come together, they realize that everything is one. Same thing with soul over matter. Everyone has heard about mind over matter. That's where you visualize strong enough or hard enough, and maybe you'll get what you want. He said there's a level higher than mind over matter, and that's connected to soul, since that's where we all come from. So this teacher has written, out of those 22 books, 11 of them are New York Times bestsellers. This one is already at the top. It's a Barnes & Noble bestseller. It's an Amazon bestseller. It's New York Times. Just hit their bestseller list. Number one in USA Today bestseller list. And it's bestseller in 4 different nonfiction categories. So he is well respected for when he teaches things, because it helps people change their life. So who am I? I am a student that came across his wisdom and teachings about 10 years ago, and I have been very blessed as a result, because I've been able to transform my life, reverse a lot of blockages in my life, including pain, including aging. I am 53 years old. I don't feel I look that. I feel I look about 45, 46, hopefully getting younger. So as I continue to practice, I believe that the body has the possibility of getting smoother skin, younger. So the practices we're going to be dealing with this week are to help us to open up what is known as the energy of the human body. Now, I'm going to start by offering a teaching. This is a teaching that explains the nature of why we get sick and how we can heal that, based on a combination of philosophies and Eastern medicine and Western medicine. So this was put together by this teacher. And he calls them Shen, Qi, and Jing blockages. So Jing is matter. There's energy and matter. So Jing is matter. Qi is energy. Everybody's done Tai Chi. What is Tai Chi? It's the movement of energy. Okay? The Qi body. So you hear the word Qi a lot. Sometimes it's spelled Q-I. So Qi is energy. And Shen is a word that reflects 3 things. Soul, heart, and mind. So for those that are watching on live stream, I know it might be difficult for you to see this, but I'll speak it so you can write it down on your own notes. So we have soul, heart, mind, we have energy, and we have matter. In present-day sickness, cancer, headaches, you name it, digestional problems. You go to see a doctor, they deal with things on the level of matter. How do they do that? If it's cancer, they cut it out. Cut out the matter. Radiate the matter. If it is a headache, what do they give you? They give you chemicals to rebalance the matter so that your headache goes away. So modern medicine deals with things at this level, adjusting the matter to fix the problem. Eastern medicine deals with things at the level of energy, qi. How many of you have ever went to an acupuncturist or an herbologist? You've received massage. Massage deals with both energy and matter. It's moving the matter and also transforming the energy, creating better energy in the body. So what does an Eastern doctor do, for example, to help you to feel better, younger, more energy? What the Eastern doctor will do is they will put needles in your body. And what that does is it helps the energy to move more smoothly. They will give you herbs that help offset the imbalances in what they call the wind or dampness or heat in the body. And so if you were to look at this from the perspective of the cell in the body, you have two cells and you have the energy running between the cells. Medicine impacts the cell, modern medicine does, and it makes the cell, if it's inflamed, which is pretty typical. What is cancer? What is a headache? It's inflammation. It's coagulation of energy in one area. And so medicine will cause the cell to adjust. If these two cells get smaller because they were inflamed, then the energy can once again course through them. Therefore, you have movement. Therefore, you have blood flow. And therefore, you have health. This is the basic concept of energy and matter. So when they adjust the energy, they try to cause it to go large spaces in the human body, and there is small spaces in the human body. The larger spaces are in between the organs and the systems. The smaller spaces are in between the cells and the cell units. And so when everything is in balance, we're in great health. So the Eastern philosophy says, if you move blood, energy will follow. So that's why they do things to move your blood, because then the healing will occur. Now what happens is, this goes in this direction. It goes downward. So you adjust the energy, the matter is adjusted. But if you adjust the matter, the energy isn't always adjusted. So sometimes Eastern philosophies and Eastern medicine works very well. Sometimes Western medicine works very well. And sometimes people get the best results when they put both of them together. But sometimes neither of them work. And they just can't figure out why. How many people have you come across that have had cancer, for example, and they cut it out, they radiate it, and the person goes through a lot of suffering, and it sort of goes away into remission, as they use the term. But then within a year or two, it comes back. Same spot or maybe a different spot. That, according to this teacher, Dr. Master Shah, is the result of a soul blockage, a soul level blockage. So what is soul? Shen is the Eastern term. Shen is spirit. Everyone and everything has a spirit, because it all comes from the same source. Now, I don't teach religion. My teacher doesn't teach religion. He teaches a philosophy, and that philosophy is based on what is loosely, very loosely called the Tao, T-A-O. I'm not going to do a lot of Tao teaching. Tao, for simple understandings, is a general philosophy on the way of life. So what's an example of the way of life? If it's 40 degrees below zero, do you walk outside in a t-shirt and think you're going to live? No. You're going against the Tao. You're going against nature's way. So the Tao means follow nature's way. Follow the logical, practical way that extends and expands life. Is eating steak and potatoes, wine and beer, heavy alcohol, going to benefit your long-term health and well-being? Not if you do it all the time. That means you're going against the Tao. So the Tao is a philosophy. Now, in this philosophy, there's a recognition that everything has a spirit or a soul, and that the soul is the boss. There is a philosophy that the soul lives forever, that the soul just keeps on experiencing things, and those experiences can impact our health and well-being, both positively and negatively. So if we have a series of unpleasant experiences, mom and dad aren't nice to us, a teacher isn't good to us, we have a car accident where it harms our neck. If we have a series of experiences, then that reflects at the level of spirit, which impacts our heart, which impacts our mind, which then impacts our energy and matter. So the way this works in terms of reversing healing, reversing aging, reversing pain, is recognizing that the blockage of anything that's happening in your life, in this case we're talking about health, health and well-being. So in this case we're talking about soul impacting your energy and matter. But it goes through the heart and the mind first. With it, everything that's ever happened, positive and negative. Now, some people would call that in the Christian doctrines, deeds. What you sow is what you reap. In the Eastern philosophies, they would call that karma. What you sow is what you reap. Same verbiage, different name. And so these tend to create our wonderful experiences and our sufferings. How do we transform something that's unpleasant so that we can get healing? We apply the four powers. The four powers are very important. Now, if you're taking notes, I'm going to erase this in just a moment here. So repeat for all those taking notes. Shen is another word for spirit or soul. Shen is soul, then heart, then mind. Qi is energy, jing is matter. Shen, qi, jing. The Tao is following nature's way. Now we're going to talk about the four powers to transform these, and I'm going to put them back up there in a little smaller so that we can apply the four powers. Okay, so we're going to put up here Shen, qi, jing, soul, heart, mind, energy, and matter. What you sow is what you reap. Good karma, bad karma. What this teacher has discovered, why he's received 11 New York Times best-selling books. You don't get there accidentally, guys. You don't sell hundreds of thousands of books accidentally. That means somebody picked it up, they received value out of it, they received healing from it, and they told somebody else. They then repeated, got value out of it, received healing, and they told somebody else. That's how you become a New York Times bestseller 11 times. So what this teacher is suggesting that you consider in your process to bring healing to you is that you reverse the blockages at the level of soul first. How do you do that? You recognize, first of all, that if you have anything negative that you're carrying around at the level of spirit, the level of soul, then it's probably there because either you or your ancestors made choices somewhere along the line that brought harm or suffering to others. Could have been stepping on a bug, it could have been kicking the cat, it could have been yelling at the children, it could have been any number of things. Lying, cheating, stealing, possibly even killing somebody when we didn't really want to if we were in the service. These create unpleasant blockages in our spiritual journey. So how do we reverse that?
Love
and forgiveness. Very simple words. They have no relationship whatsoever to a religion, but religions will usually talk about them because they carry the greatest power to transform our life. This is simply a philosophy of the nature of the Tao. You don't go outside when it's sub-zero temperatures in your t-shirt. That goes against the Tao. If you want to reverse negativity, you do the positive. That is following the nature of Tao. That is what Tao Te Ching is all about, following nature's way. So when we apply love and forgiveness properly, we can start reversing those things that create suffering in our life. Does that make sense to everybody so far? Okay. We do that using four powers. Now, the first three you're already familiar with. Has everybody here heard of mind power? Mind power. One sentence secret, what you focus on is what you receive. If you focus on light coming to the area of suffering, you receive light in that area of suffering. If you focus on something negative over and over and over and over and over, there's a high likelihood you'll get more of what you're focusing on. Mind power is creative visualization. Creative visualization. That's mind power. So that's one of the four powers. Most everybody in here has heard of it. Even mind over matter. When that was talked about, mind over matter was first brought up probably several hundred years ago, but it was documented in the early 1900s. And the people that started talking about it were listed as quacks. What you think about is what you're going to actually get into your life. Are you kidding me? You're a quack. You're nuts. Today, no one even questions it. They know absolutely clearly that what you think about positive and negative does have a definite impact in your life. So soul power is the fourth power. We're going to come back to that. But it is something that people might question until it becomes validated. The next power is sound power. Sound power. Now, some people have heard of crystal bowls. Some people play music. They feel better, like Beethoven. If you play heavy metal, da-da-da-da-da, chances are it's not going to help your health and well-being as much as maybe Beethoven would, because sound carries vibrational frequencies that can heal and balance. The mind can create a focus of vibrational frequencies that can heal and balance. What is, when they're Eastern medicine is adjusting the chi, what are they adjusting? Energy, vibrational frequency. Same thing with the matter. And so sound can assist. The one sentence secret is, what you chant is what you become. What you chant is what you become. That's the one sentence secret. So today, when we do this practice, we'll be employing sound power. We will use a specific sound that will vibrate an area of the body that will help to adjust the energy in the matter and release the blockages. The next power is body power. What is body power? Body power is placing your hands in a certain way that brings more energy to that area that causes the matter to adjust and move. For example, everybody do this with me. Put your hands in front of yourself. Your left hand, grab your thumb. Squeeze it. Wrap your palms around. Just drop them on there. Okay, now your grip is pretty tight. Now put your thumb, your knuckle of your thumb in your belly button. This is one example of body power for boosting power to the entire lower abdomen. Okay, you can release now. Why would you boost power to the entire lower abdomen if you held your hands like that? Well, you're going to add the other things, of course, but the reason it works is because you're gripping your thumb and you're wrapping your hands together, which cause the energy of each of the fingers, which are associated with organs, that goes back to Eastern philosophies, each finger is associated with the major organ. But when you wrap your hands around each other, you are focusing on all major organs. When you put your hand on your lower abdomen and your mind goes down there, you add sound power down there, body power down there, then you're bringing all of the light, the sound, and the vibration into that area. What's down here? Basically, science calls the lower part of your body your second brain. This has nothing to do with this teaching, but just on a side note, they've discovered that autistic children, the problem is not here. It's all down here. They have huge imbalances of the gastrointestinal system that create a lot of toxins in the bloodstream that then go to the brain and cause a problem in the brain. The problem is down here. So that's another example of why we would use body power. The final and most important power was brought to humanity through this teacher's teacher. Master Sha trained with many very high-level teachers that people would never hear about. They're very humble, they live in the mountains, but they understand the sacred secrets from 5,000 years ago. And that is called soul power. What is soul power? Soul power is saying hello. It's acknowledging that your soul came before you, the physical being. It's acknowledging that your soul is the boss. Now, what I'm about to share with you is new information to you. And I'm not asking you to accept it. I'm asking you to recognize that it's a possibility and that this teacher has become a world-renowned healer because of this teaching and because of people putting it into practice and getting results. So don't have to believe what I'm about to share with you, but if you put it into practice, you might find that you get results too, which will help you to validate that there's a possibility that what he's sharing is accurate. So what this teacher teaches is that there is one creator, source, whatever you want to call it, God, everyone has their own name, and that creator created everything. Every speck of energy, every speck of matter that makes up your body was made by your creator. The chair that you're sitting on at home on the computer here in this classroom is made up of energy and matter. Who made the energy and matter? Creator. Everything is made up of energy and matter. Therefore, everything has spirit of creator in it. I don't think anyone would have an issue with that understanding. What he teaches is that that spirit is on its own soul journey. Every speck of energy and matter is learning. It's serving. It's becoming more evolved as it moves all the way back to original creation. All souls, according to this philosophy, are on their way back to original creator. And so the chair that you're sitting on, which is made up of energy and matter, is serving you. Because it's doing something positive, good, and valuable for you, it is getting good service, good virtue, good karma, good deeds, whatever you want to call it. And eventually, with billions of years, it can find its way into the form of a human being, and so forth. So, the basic understanding of soul is that it originates from source, and that everything has a soul. So that would also mean the soul of your knee that causes you pain. Your knee has a soul. Why? Because it's made up of energy and matter that comes from source. That would mean that the liver cancer has a soul. That would mean that everything has that spirit nature in it. So let's imagine that someone you don't even know, grandpa, maybe great-grandpa, he was in the war, and that in that war, he shot out people's knees, because that's what his boss taught him to do, to disable them. And so he was just doing what he was told. He's a good person. But then that created a spiritual debt that fell through the ancestral tree down to you. That's spoken about in all belief systems, so I don't believe anyone would have a blockage with that perspective. So that means that that may be the source or the soul blockage that's at the level of your knee. it could have originated through the family tree. You might have done nothing to hurt anybody's feelings. So how do we address it using these four powers? We ask for forgiveness, and we offer love to the needy. That's where the blockage is at. Why wouldn't we send the love and forgiveness to that area using these four powers? Okay? So that's an example of how we would do this. So, all of you on live stream, all of you that are here today, choose an area of your physical body that has any pain. Could be your neck, could be your lower back, could be your knee, could be headache, could be any part of your body, could be that one finger that's always bothered you for 20 years. Choose that area, and we're going to apply these four powers step by step. Soul power is the most important. People have been doing these and have already had results just doing these. But when we put them together is when we get the greatest value. When we add love and forgiveness is when we start to reverse things much faster. Okay? So, how do we do that? We start by what's called saying hello. You say hello. You say hello to the soul of your need. Because the soul of your knee has probably never heard anybody talk to, first of all. We have sore backs. Oh, my aching back. I have a bad back. I have a bad knee. I have a bad back. I have a bad... How many times does somebody say that in their life if their back is sore? 10, 20, 30 years, I have a bad back. They say that for 20 years. So what does the soul of your back think? Okay, I'm a bad back. I did the best I could, but I guess I'm a bad back. Could you imagine saying that to your kid for 20 years? You're a bad kid. What's that going to do to that kid? We have to love every part of our body. Simple message, the Tao. What is the Tao? Follow nature's way. Give love to whatever parts of our body are hurting us. Very simple teaching. So we say hello. I'll give you an example before we do it. Dear the soul of my lower back, I love you. Instead of the other messages it might have been giving it. You have the ability to heal yourself. Please do a good job. That's it. That's called saying hello. We're talking to that soul of our body with love. Now the next step is asking for forgiveness. Please forgive me if I have said anything negative to you. Dear all souls, if I or my ancestors did anything that caused your back to suffer, I truly apologize on behalf of myself and my ancestors. I'm sure they did not mean it, but if they did, I deeply, deeply apologize. Please forgive us. Very simple. Each one of those, love takes what, 10 seconds? Forgiveness takes 20 seconds. But now you've done something you've never done before for that area. You've given it attention with love and forgiveness. So let's apply all of these. So choose your area. I'm going to go ahead and focus on my lower back and hips. We're going to use our body power first. Okay? So how do we do that? We're going to go ahead, to make it simple, we're going to go ahead and put, if you can't reach it with both hands, just put one hand over that area. If you can't reach it, point to the area with your hand. Okay? But if you can reach it, just put your hand on that area. If you can put both hands there, great. Go ahead and put both hands there. If you cannot, put the second hand right over your lower abdomen. We're just going to keep this body power part very simple, okay? I'm going to put one hand on my lower back, one hand on my lower abdomen. Okay. So now we start out with soul power. So I'll give you the say hello. You fill in the body part. So dear the soul of my lower back, you state whatever you have. You can be quiet. You can say it silently. Here. I love you. I truly appreciate you. If it's your arm, I could not do my job. I could not sign papers. I cannot do anything if it wasn't for you. I truly am grateful for you. Thank you for all these years that you've served me. If it's your lower back, give it gratitude. You have the ability to heal yourself. Do a good job. Thank you. Now, sound power. For the sound power, We're simply going to chant the words divine love. Why? Because divine is the highest frequency, and love is also the highest frequency, since love and divine are the same thing. We're going to chant divine love. We might also chant divine forgiveness, but those are the two sound power or mantra that we'll chant. What you chant is what you become. That is the one sentence secret. If you chant divine love, if you chant divine forgiveness, that's what you could become, especially for the area you're focused on. So that's the sound power. For mind power, I want you to visualize golden light in that area, like a golden light bulb coming into that area, spinning around. It doesn't matter what direction it spins. Just see it spinning golden light, okay? And for body power, we've already done that. So we've done the four powers. Keep your eyes closed. You don't need to see me. And let us chant divine love. Focus on your area of suffering with golden light. Divine love. Divine love. Divine love. Divine love. Divine love heals me. 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 Divine love, divine love, divine love. And now we say it faster. Divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love. As I say it faster, see the golden light get brighter, brighter, brighter. Divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love, divine love. Divine love, 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 divine love. Chant in your heads. Divine love, divine love. Feel God's love, the divine's love, blessing you, healing the area. I love, 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 divine forgiveness. Sending your forgiveness on behalf of you and your ancestors to any souls that have been harmed in that area. Divine forgiveness. Divine forgiveness. Divine forgiveness. Divine forgiveness. Divine forgiveness. Divine forgiveness. Divine forgiveness, 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 divine forgiveness. Divine forgiveness, 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 divine light, divine light, divine light, divine light, divine light, see divine's light. Divine light, 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 divine light. Divine light, divine light, divine light, divine light, divine light, divine light, We say hao, which is a Mandarin Chinese word that means perfect, finished. We say thank you three times. First thank you is to our beloved Creator. The second thank you is to all of the blessings that came to us, to all of the holy beings that have come to serve. The third thank you is to our own soul and to all those that have forgiven us. So we're very grateful. Okay, how do you feel? My mistake, I should have asked you to check in beforehand your level of discomfort in that area. I usually ask you, was it 4, 5, 6, 7, 8? And then you can measure again afterwards. Now we chanted for about 8 minutes. So you might have had 0 result, you might have had a 5%, a 30%, 50% result. Some maybe have 100% result. Go ahead and post on live stream. Did you have any results in the room? Okay. So, what happens when we do this? Why does this help? And what can we do to cause even more and greater results? Everything, according to this philosophy, is related to a soul-level blockage. That then creates a message at the level of heart. If the soul carries with it, therefore the mind carries negative messages. Therefore that impacts the energy of the area. Therefore that impacts the matter of the area. The reason many of the medical approaches today aren't getting to the core or can only cause so much result is because they try to go this direction. They're not getting the results they'd like. When we deal with things at the level of soul, now one thing we have to remember is a soul level blockage is one that has been with us for a while. If we have a headache, we take an aspirin, it goes away, it doesn't come back, that's not a soul level blockage, that's a headache. Okay? If we've had something for a while, that means there's a negativity associated with it, according to this perspective. So how long has that negativity been there? How long has your pain been there? Okay? If it's been long-standing and no matter what you've done, it keeps coming back, then 8 minutes of practice is not going to remove 20 years of blockage. Not going to happen, guys. You have to be consistent. People that have chronic illnesses, it's recommended you do every day 2 hours of practice. Do extended forgiveness practice. Do extended love. All at once, very difficult. 15 minutes here, half hour there, 15 minutes there. Much easier. Now, that's if you're chronic. I mean, chronic means you're on your way to dying if you don't do something. That's when you have the time, because you're probably not working if it's chronic. So you have the time to put 2 hours in. Again and again and again, people that apply this see the results. So when we are doing this, what is happening? Visually speaking, here is your soul, and here is your body. Your soul is a carbon copy of your body. The blockage is held up here. Maybe it's in the heart, if you have heart conditions, maybe it's in the knee, if you have knee conditions, but that's where the blockage originates. When you bring love and forgiveness to the area at the soul level, which it's waiting to be released through forgiveness, it's waiting to be released through love, then the physical body responds. Heal the soul first, and the mind and the body follows. That is the one sentence secret that this teacher brought with his very first book 20 years ago. He hasn't changed the ideology since, and it is proven that it's not needed to be changed because literally hundreds of thousands of people have seen tremendous results. Healing the level of the soul first by applying love and forgiveness and the four powers brings results, no question about it. All you have to do is be consistent, and you will also have that proof in the pudding, as they say. So when we're doing this, and we're healing things at the level of soul, how does it change down here? Well, remember, down here we are made up of energy and matter. The energy is running between the cells, and they are out of balance. The energy is not converting to matter. The matter is not converting back to energy and relative balance. They're not operating at peak efficiency. Reason why? It's because of the blockage. It starts up here, but it's reflected down here. So when you change the frequency up here through love, which is our original thing, another way to look at this is, what are we originally? From our very first original beginning, when the divine, when our creator split himself up and we become all specks of creator, what are we originally? We are love. That's what creator is. So it stands to reason that when we bring the frequency of the imbalances back to our original state, back to our original nature, that the physical body would then adjust to match to what we originally are. And the blockage at the physical level would naturally dissolve, would naturally go away. That is why all of those here in this room, all of those that are online, need to practice more. That is why you need to do forgiveness more. Because if you or your ancestors have harmed people, greed, corruption, lying, cheating, stealing, telling people wrong information, giving them wrong teachings that hurt their soul journey, telling somebody you love them and then changing your mind, I'll love forever, and then they're crushed. All of these different areas can create blockages in our physical body. They can create emotional blockages. They can create mind blockages. They can create blockages in every aspect of our life. And all we need to do is apply love and forgiveness consistently. So this is the baseline teachings. Heal the soul first. The mind and body follows. The soul is the boss. The four powers, soul power, mind power, body power, sound power. And the order of healing. So basically, that's everything in a nutshell that Master Shah teaches. If you look at any of his 20 books, he goes and he teaches all these different mantras. He offers many different blessings. But what is it really doing? It's clearing these blockages at the level of source, level of origination. So I encourage you to come back every Thursday, 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock, because I will be teaching on this same subject matter for specific body parts. Heart is next week. Brain is after that. After that, I think it's kidneys and so forth. You might not feel you have blockage in these areas, but everybody does on some level. You might be lethargic in the mornings. It takes a half hour before you get up, or you have to have coffee regardless. But when you do blessings for the heart, which we're going to do for 30 minutes when you're here, we're just going to bless the heart for 30 minutes, then you could find the next day you're not so lethargic the next day, that things are working better, that your face is not so light, that it's more red, it's more flush. You might find that you're sleeping a little bit better because the heart and the kidneys are related. In Eastern philosophy, the heart is fire. The kidneys are a watcher. If they're in balance, you sleep really good. If they're out of balance, you can have sleep deprivation. So this is an example of why it's a value to balance these five major organs that we'll be talking about, plus the brain, in these next six sessions. So I encourage all to come back. I'm going to offer everybody a blessing at this time. I've been blessed to receive what's called healing transmissions from Dr. and Master Shah. I'm not going to talk too much about it, but I'm going to give you a little bit of insight. This teacher is exceedingly unique in the world. There's not too many people that have received unique healing abilities. He gives all credit to the Creator. He takes zero credit. And he said he didn't have it when he started. He just trained just like everybody else did. Studied with the Masters. He just did what he was taught to do. And he started offering healing, and the healing became quite profound. And over time, it's become even more profound. He has the unique ability to put power into things or transfer it to people. In ancient literature, you might have read once or twice in your life where, you know, the master has a student that follows him for 30 years, and they cook for him, and they make his clothes, and they carry the wood on their back for 30 years. The teacher teaches them nothing, and then after 30 years, and the master gets ready to die, he touches his forehead, and all the power transfers to the student. That's the story. I haven't not believed it, but I questioned that that was possible. And about 9 years ago, when I met this master, he was doing healing for people. I saw him ask if anybody in the audience had major pain, major suffering. And he didn't ask for minor pain or suffering. Major pain, major suffering. 9 out of 10 stuff. He didn't play around. And so he would ask them to come up. They would explain what they'd been through, chiropractor, this, that, whatever, what worked, what didn't work, how long they had it, what was their pain level. He would never touch them. He would then ask Divine to do the service, and he would move his hands, and the person's pain would diminish. It usually take about 10-15 minutes, and the person's pain would go down, if not to zero, very close to zero. And I watched this. I watched it for about a year, trying to comprehend and understand how it worked, which is what I'm teaching you now. Now I know how it works. But he explained that he had to do what I taught you today. Chant, body posture, soul power. He taught that for 10 years before he was given the authority to offer blessings. Basically, the Divine's offering it through him. Again, he never takes credit for it. So when I was at this retreat watching him do this, and then the second year I went back, on the second year, he said something that caught my attention. He said, I'm looking for healers. I'm looking for people that can offer healing. And I was like, wow. If I can do a fraction of what I see this guy do, I'm curious. I'm interested. And so I paid $1,000. He said, I don't want you to pay me $1,000. I want you to pay, he said. He said, the reason why is because people need to learn self-healing. I said, wow, $1,000, that's a lot of money. But I went ahead and I borrowed the money, actually. And I'm sitting in the audience. There's about 500 people. And from on the stage, he said the word transmission. He says, okay, you all received your healing power. I didn't see anything, I didn't feel anything, and this man on stage is telling me I now have healing power. Okay, we'll find out. I'm going to go home. I was on the Big Island at that time. I'm going to go home and find out if this actually works. So I went home. I had 5 roommates, very big house we lived in. And I said, hey, any of you guys got pain? I got this healing power thing. I want to see if it works. I'm going to be testing it for a while, see if this stuff actually works. Because that's how I was taught, you know, don't believe it until you see it. So you know it works. And so the first person was my roommate, Barry, one of my roommates. And I found out that he had quite a bit of lower back pain. I never knew that. He's in construction, so it makes sense, but I never realized it. And so I got the piece of paper that says how to turn on the healing transmission. You put your hand up like this, and you ask God to do the work, and blah, blah, blah. And so I did exactly what the piece of paper said. And I felt a little bit of heat in my hand, but I wasn't sure, you know, if it was my imagination. And I did it about, I don't know, 8-10 minutes. And I said, okay, Barry, any results? And Barry said, you know, it's amazing. I felt like there was a knot unwinding in my back, like literally somebody was unwinding a knot. I said, well, can you please get up and walk around? Because they say you're supposed to walk around before you check. So he walked around for a minute, and he said, he's bending over, and he's doing all kinds of stuff. And he said, I can't believe it. He said, my pain is gone. And you know what I said to him? I said, okay. I'll check back with you in 3 weeks, because I did not believe it. I checked back, it was about a month later, And so I'm in the kitchen. I said, "Hey, Barry, how's your back?" And he said, "Huh? My back? Huh? No, it's fine." And he just went about, you know, making his sandwich, whatever it was. He didn't even think about it. It was like he did. It's just been gone ever since. So after 8 years of working with this master, I'm very confident of the ability to offer a blessing. So everyone make a request. Everybody online, everyone in the room, make a request for one area that you would like a blessing for. And then I will ask my healing treasure to offer you a blessing. And you don't make that request to divine. You just silently. I don't need to hear it or know what it is. That's between you and God. Blessing begin. I will chant a soul song to assist in the healing. Love you, love you. Thank you to my healing treasure. You can return now. So thank you all for in this room that have come. Thank you to all the souls in this room that have come. Thank you to all those online for watching today. I am grateful for your patience. I apologize I did not to speak directly to all you online. Please make any comments if you received any benefits from today's blessings or teachings. Make sure to share the video afterwards. All those in the room, please share this with anybody that you know you feel can benefit from these teachings and healings. Next week we'll be focusing on the heart, and it will be Thursday, 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock. Until then, we'll see you, and aloha. Bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye.